Hi, my name is Laura, and I'm going to talk to you more about the Neuman Systems model. In particular, we'll take a closer look at the aspect of stressors, with my focus being on extrapersonal stressors. So far, through our readings and lectures, we've learned about Betty Neuman's holistic systems model as it is applied to nursing. I will walk us through a brief review of the model. As you know, the client, or client system, is seen as a dynamic human being, which is depicted in this diagram by a series of concentric circles. The inner circle, or core, represents the client's basic survival factors, which include genetic endowment, organ strength, or weakness, and other factors. The circles that flow outward from the core represent the lines of protection the client has to maintain homeostasis. The closest circles surrounding the core are the lines of resistance, which cause the reaction of symptoms when stressors penetrate the client's normal line of defense. The normal line of defense is the client's baseline level of health that has developed over time through adaptation. The outermost circle represents the flexible line of defense, which protects the client's normal line of defense from invasion by stressors. This line of defense. Next, to refresh your memory, there are five client system variables which Neuman states originate in the core and affect how the client responds to life. The first one is physiological variables, which basically describe the client's physical body, all the way from cells to organ systems. Number two is psychological variables, which include cognitive and emotional processes. Three is sociocultural variables. These include social and cultural factors in the client's life. Number four is developmental variables. These refer to the accomplishment of developmental tasks in a client's lifespan. And number five, spiritual variables, pertain to the client's understanding of the meaning of life and faith. The client environments are divided into three types. The first is internal environment. This refers to the forces and influences that are contained within the client system. The second type of environment is external environment. This includes the forces and influence that are outside of the client system. The third environment, the created environment, represents the client's unconscious assembling of all the system variables toward system stability and integrity. What are stressors? Betty Neuman talks about stressors in her model and defines them as tension-producing stimuli that have the potential to cause system instability. Like this battery with the positive and negative ends, stressors can produce positive or negative outcomes for a client, depending upon the client's perception of the stressor and their ability to deal with the stressor's effects. Stressors that are perceived as positive are considered eustress, and stressors perceived as negative are, well, just plain stress. The Neuman Systems model outlines three types of environmental stressors that a client experiences. I will give you the most general definitions of the first two stressors and then discuss the third stressor, which is my assignment, more in depth. The first, intrapersonal stressors, are internal to the client system. It is as if the client is versing him or herself. Number two, interpersonal stressors, are external to the client system, but at close range. It is as if the client is versing others or possibly role expectations. The third type of stressor, which is my focus, is extrapersonal stressors. These occur outside the client system boundaries, but at farther range. It is as if the client is versing something he or she has less control over. Some examples of extrapersonal stressors are financial circumstances. Think about whether or not there's a lack of money in the household. Another example is employment status or environment. This could be anything from unemployment, underemployment, or possibly a client's employer expects excessive overtime to be worked. Another stressor could be housing situation, whether or not someone rents, owns, or perhaps is experiencing potential homelessness. A stressor that is also extrapersonal in nature is a client's relationship or access to the community health agencies. This could include just general access to health care or a client's insurance status when it comes to health care. And social policies. They could be a little more far-reaching and definitely further out of the client's control, anything relating from child care to welfare policy. The extrapersonal stressors can also influence the intrapersonal and interpersonal stressors. One scenario that I came up with involving extrapersonal stressors would be the case of a client who receives a cancer diagnosis. If the cancer compromises the system enough for the client, they could possibly lose their employment. This loss of income would definitely be a major factor as they deal with expensive medical treatments, medications, and therapies. The extrapersonal stressors of job loss and financial burden would undoubtedly cause the client negative stress, as well as interact with many other intrapersonal and interpersonal stressors. Next, I did find a good illustration of a man dealing with multiple stressors, especially the extrapersonal ones. It's Will Smith's character named Chris Gardner in the movie The Pursuit of Happiness. I'll tell you a little bit about him. Chris is a hardworking salesman who invested his life savings in a medical product that just doesn't sell. Unable to provide a steady income for his family, Chris's wife tires of being the main breadwinner in a dead-end job herself and leaves him with their 5-year-old son. Already behind on the rent and then losing his wife's stable income, Chris and his son are evicted from their apartment. The film clip I've selected to show you shows Chris and his son on their first night of being homeless.
It's not a time machine. Dad, it's not a time machine. Guy said it was a time machine. It's not a time machine. He was wrong.
What guy?
The guy. He was at the park. He said it was a time machine.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
It is.
No, it's not.
All we gotta do is push this black button right here. You wanna push it?
Okay.
Come on. Come on, man. Right here. Wait a minute. Where you want to go?
Almost someplace from before.
You gotta close your eyes.
You close your eyes. I want to see.
All right, come on. We'll push it together. You gotta close your eyes. Close your eyes. It takes a few seconds. Oh, my goodness. What? Open, open, open.
What is it?
Dinosaurs.
Where?
You don't see all these dinosaurs? Look around. Look at all these dinosaurs. Do you see them?
Yeah.
I mean, come on, come on, come on. Wait, watch out.
What is it?
Don't step in the fire. We're cavemen. And we need this fire because there's no electricity and it's cold out here, okay?
Watch out, watch
Whoa,
out.
Whoa, oh my goodness. A T-Rex. That's a T. Get your stuff. Get your stuff. Get it. We gotta find someplace safe.
What?
We need a cave.
A cave?
We gotta find a cave. Come on. Come on, come on. Wait, watch your back. We got, here it is. Here's a cave. Come on. Right here, right here. Go, go, go. Get it, get it. Hurry, hurry. Hurry.
Are we safe?
Yeah, I think so.
Was a scene from The Pursuit of Happiness. And if you notice my slide, happiness does have a variation in spelling. Not my choice, but the film creators. So we did see in the film clip that Chris Gardner was facing the extrapersonal stressors of loss of income and loss of home, taking shelter with his son in the men's room of the subway station. He was, of course, also dealing with numerous intrapersonal and interpersonal stressors simultaneously. It's interesting to note how Chris tried to focus on his son's immediate psychological needs by turning their bleak circumstances into a kind of adventure, even if only for a brief time. Yet, once he and his son were safe in the cave of the men's room, Chris's vulnerability was observed, as he kept tearful vigil, holding his sleeping son on the floor with him. Chris's behaviors demonstrated the interplay of his own physical, psychological, sociocultural, developmental, and spiritual variables in dealing with all of his stressors. To recap, extrapersonal stressors are stressors that are external to the client system, occurring at a farther distance than interpersonal stressors. They are factors that a client typically has less control over than other stressors. They may include financial circumstances, employment status or environment, housing situation, relationship or access to community healthcare agencies, and social policies. Well, through the review and examples I've provided, I hope that you've gained a bit more understanding of extrapersonal stressors according to the Neuman Systems model. Thank you very much for listening.